Hey everybody, Jeff Archfiend here. Well, last 40 episodes. What did we have again? Sorry, it's been a while since I last saw them. I'm doing these in groups, so it's a case of like, I have to remind myself what they were. Keep Beach City Weird. All the way up to On the Run. Alright, now I'm with you. Well, we got to see, well, more background story for Amethyst. Awesome. And in turn, the other gems. Via that. It's interesting because we're also getting some more stuff with the homeworld gems in case of Peridot with the warp tour. So that's gonna be interesting in the future. What else do we have here? Keep Beach City Weird. I'm gonna guess there was some kind of telltale hints that will linger on to the end. So that's gonna be interesting. So we've discovered that Steven's got some control over his powers, kind of, even if it's accidental. He's inherited some of his mother's abilities, as we saw in Watermelon Steven. Seriously, if those watermelons don't make a reoccurrence later on, I'm going to be slightly disappointed. And then there's the lion. Oh yes, the lion. So many secrets, so many lies. Lions. So the lion is definitely connected to Rose. Well, the fact that it is holding her storage space, knows where her training room is. Okay, and I will admit, I did slightly tear up with that episode. Not full on cry, but there was something watering there. Okay? You happy? You know who you are. Anyway, at least now we know why Garnet's always able to get into the right place at the right time. She can see into the future! Or possible futures! Which, to be honest, I quite like that it's actually possible futures and not a definite down the road scene into the future. Because, well, there's been a few shows where they've done it's a case like they can see definitively into the future. And that always kind of bugged me a little because predestiny, fate, call it what you will, even, that's always been a kind of I like shows where predestiny is more of a suggestion than any actual predetermined fate. Destiny's a suggestion. It's an ultimate goal on how you get there, but the road you take to get there is your own choice. So, yeah, we might all have a destiny, but it's how we get there that's our decisions. Which is kind of what Garnet had, so. But, yeah, it shows that even Garnet can screw up. Big time! Yeah, and the fact that we definitely got more development in terms of the gems and the relationship with Steven, and Steven in his relationship with the gems in turn, with the test episode. Which is very nice, very good. The fact that the gems themselves are confused on how to actually deal with Steven. That's nice. On the outside, they're very reassuring, they seem to be in control. They seem to know what they're doing, but deep down, they have no clue. Which is actually fair enough. I mean, Greg is a single dad since Rose Quartz gave up her life to give birth to Steven. And the three crystal gems, well, I don't think they've ever raised a kid before. And the fact that Steven's never gone to school either indicates that, they don't seem to know what's going on either with, like, how human society works. Although I'm assuming Greg has some part in that as well. So, yeah, we've gotten some more development, getting more connections. It'd be interesting to see if Connie's family makes a reappearance again, because that was amusing seeing them react with the gems in Fusion Cuisine. And good God, 1,000 years without television. He's screwed. The kid is screwed. That is some tough love right there. And also quite possibly able to perform. Given that we saw with the Too Many Birthdays episode that Steven may possibly live to be that old. I have no idea. But yeah. very good so far. I'm looking forward to the next bunch of videos. And quick update, I won't be doing a thoughts video after episode 50. I'll be saving that till the end of the season, so that'll be coming out after episode 52. And yes, I did some looking up, so it's a case of like, what I said originally was good with like 49 episodes for the first season, I was on about like the airtime, but apparently there was some screw up or something on Cartoon Network's end when they had certain episodes airing after when they were supposed to be because of some mishmash Stephen bomb thing that they did. I don't know. But yeah, so I'll be doing the 52 episodes and then a thoughts on the season as a whole rather than just the last few episodes. The start of it will be the last few episodes and then it'll be the last or half will be the season as a whole. So yeah. Jeff Archfiend, out.